Well, now take down your fishing pole and meet me at the fishing hole. We may not get a bite all day, but don't you rush away. What a great place to rest your bones, and mighty fine for skipping stones. You'll feel fresh as a lemonade, setting in the shade. Whether it's hot, whether it's cool, oh, what a spot for whistling like a fool. What a fine day to take a stroll and wander by the fishing hole. I can't think of a better way to pass the time of day. We'll have no need to call the road when we get to the vision hole. There'll be you, me, and old dog Trey to doodle time away. Put a poker back, we'll cool our toes in dewy grass, or else pull up a weed to chaw and maybe set and jaw. Hang around, taking our ease, watching that hound, us scratching at his flea. Come on, take down your fishing pole and meet me at the fishing hole. I can't think of a better way to pass the time of day.
Sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, the skipper brave and sure. Five passengers
that is
sailed
awesome.
That day for
look at
a three-hour tour. A three-hour tour.
No, keep the Lakers.
But when this started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed.
Oh, okay.
If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. The minnow would be lost. The ship's aground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too. The millionaire and his wife, the movie star, the professor and Mary Ann.
I'm swimming. I'm going back up.
This is really important. This is when we got stuck. See? The great river people got us stuck.
Mom, get the dog away from me, please.
Right here? Ooh. Ooh. That was pretty.
Steve, you're up. Steve, you're up.
The kids.
I don't need this, okay? Okay, here.